Good evening to the people of California, and good evening to my fellow Americans. You know, we have unresolved issues in this country that, for some reason, we have 535 members of Congress that can't debate them successfully. We can't come up with a resolution. Maybe that tells our Congress that it may be none of your damn business. Maybe it's not government's problem to solve all of the issues in this country. Maybe it's the people's problem. Maybe it is the fact that the people of this country have resolved within themselves not to resolve the issues based upon their own fear. Well, you know, as Franklin Delano Roosevelt once said, who led us through World War II, my grandfathers were big fans until I came around. Both of my grandfathers voted for FDR. Maybe we have nothing to fear but fear itself. We are fearing the political establishment. We are fearing private sector security here in this country. We are fearing religion, race, gender, and even sexual orientation. Well, the one thing I will say tonight is I believe, beyond a shadow of a doubt, that the one thing my party, the Republican Party, who I'm proud of in most areas, has failed, and that is with regard to our men and women in uniform who happen to be gay or lesbian. I support gays and lesbians in the military. I support them because they're already there, doing the heavy lifting for all of us. And if you ask 77% of the American people in this country whether or not they support gays and lesbians in the military, they will tell you, yes, they do. The rest of those percentage points have to get over their own damn prejudice. You know, after 9/11, I think we were all prejudiced from a certain standpoint with regard to Muslim Americans. I think I am guilty of doing that myself. When David Ramadan was elected in Virginia this past election, I was sure that was the wrong thing to do. If you listen to my broadcast on Louisa Radio, you will find that that was the only race I didn't call. I've learned a lot from that, Mr. Ramadan. I've learned a lot about my own prejudice, and I apologize to the American people for it. We have to get over the scars of 9/11 by protecting our country against foreign and domestic terrorists alike. Now, as far as I can tell, many of our terrorists, in an economic point of view, already sit in Congress. They're there. Some of them are retiring the next election. Good riddance. Now, in the spirit of integrity, I won't mention their names, but you know who they are. When you allow Freddie Mac and Fannie Mae to do their job for you, you have disparaged the American people. You have robbed them of their homes and their hopes. Shame on you. Today in California, we have the same thing going on. While Governor Jerry Brown has gone against the big banks, throughout the past, he has supported them. Jerry Brown is a hypocrite. Some of my Republican friends in my party are also hypocrites. You can't have it your way. You cannot have your cake and eat it too. It's just not the natural order of things in our country. The fact is, folks, The American people are pissed off. I apologize if that's too forward, but it's the damn truth. If Harry Truman was here today, he would tell you the same thing. It's time for change. Not the kind of change Barack Obama promised you, but the kind of change you can really believe in. So tonight, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to give you that change. Here stands before you one Republican. One Republican who raises two children with a wife that I love. I love her beyond politics or anything else. I would even die for her. What Jerry Brown loves are big unions. Jerry, you had the opportunity years ago to pioneer this with the American people. When you ran against Bill Clinton, you played it politically correct. You didn't call it like you saw it. My wife is a transgendered woman, and I'm proud of her. She is a woman in every sense of the word. My children are happier for it. What angers me at this hour is that my party does not recognize the fact that gays and lesbians already serve in the U.S. military. They have since Alexander the Great, and they have since the Greek times. Ever since our nation was founded, we have had gays and lesbians throughout history. If you want to talk about a moral gauge, and I'm talking to the Republican Party tonight, if you want to talk about a moral gauge, then you talk to me eyeball to eyeball. And I want to know how you drop the ball on the abortion issue. How can you tell the American people in a referendum that it's okay that a woman has a right to her own body? She has a right to an abortion as long as it has to do with her, her doctor, and her God. How dare you? How dare you tell the American people who are gays and lesbians in this country that they don't have a right to their own body? And that it's only an issue between their body, their person, their doctor, and their God. You can't legalize genocide in this country simply because it's a feminist issue. If you're talking about human rights and the right to the body, then what you need to do is stay out of my bedroom. You need to stay out of my wife's bedroom. The government needs to stay out of every bedroom, and I'm telling former Attorney General Ed Meese, you are wrong, sir. You are wrong. While people have said that racism and sexual orientation, whether you're black or you're gay, it's not the same thing. Well, it is. It's just that our country progressed long enough to end the racial issue in this country. Folks, it is not about American rights alone. It is about human rights. It is about the fact that you're going to have gays and lesbians in your family. Many of you tonight that I'm speaking to know them. You have them. You have them as sons or daughters. And while people in the Republican Party, and many on the left also, suggest that it's a moral issue, No, my friends. The moral issue is allowing legalized genocide in this country. And telling gays and lesbians who are adults, who had the chance to make their choices, who chose their rights above the perceptions of their church, or their Congress, or their state legislatures, that they don't have the same right? What you did to the Supreme Court, to the Congress of the United States, what you did was create a fiasco out of the U.S. Constitution. I believe, I saw a video today by Zach Wall, who was a son born of two lesbian parents. Zach is an articulate, conservative, God-fearing young man. He's the real deal. I caught hell over supporting Zach's statement, and to this day, I stand by it. We can't choose where we come from. And I'd rather have two lesbian parents supporting Zach Wall and raising him than two heterosexual parents that can't get along. Maybe more domestic abuse would be trimmed down. Maybe the divorce rate would go down. You know, one of my large heroes in history, other than Winston Churchill, was Ronald Reagan. But he was also divorced. The first divorced president in the history of the United States. John Kennedy, when he ran for president, could not even count on the fact that if his wife divorced him, he could be elected president. You know what, folks, I've always said, and I say tonight to you, it's not about politics, it's about people. I have said that from day one. I stand by the fact that the 1973 total force law that was passed is unconstitutional. Every governor in every state in this union should have control of their militia. What it comes down to, folks, is let the people decide the fate of this nation, not your bureaucrats. Not your Republicans or Democrats or your independents. Not your gays, lesbians, or heterosexuals. Let the American people decide. To the Muslim community tonight, you have done a great disservice to the Middle East. You have once again allowed the extremists to hijack your nations. And for that, I'm certain the U.S. will be there to defend freedom. But folks, the one thing I want to say tonight is, if you've never known freedom, you have no idea what the definition is. You have no idea what it means to be free. That is why America is so damn unique in the world. That is why we are struggling to maintain a balance in our nation. Not because we're perfect, but because we do make mistakes. Not because we're right, but because sometimes we're wrong. But the balance of our nation, the balance of humanity, depends upon that fire that burns within our souls. The fire to be free. The willingness to teach people to be free after you've been free. The willingness to look the American people or the world in the eye and say America has the best gauge on freedom and liberty and justice, whether social or by the law. When it comes to gays and lesbians in the military, or even gay marriage, I know many of my friends will disagree with me, and I don't blame them. They have their belief, and I respect it. What I don't respect is a Supreme Court who upholds Roe v. Wade in the name of human rights when it comes to the body. The only excuse they won the abortion issue on was that woman's body. It belongs to her, her doctor, and her God. Well, folks, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but you can't have your cake and eat it too. This isn't a bakery. This is the American people. And they will speak. And they will speak honestly every single time. Now, for those liberal friends out there who, and some of my conservative friends even, who will toast me, let me be honest with you right off the bat. I have made some grave mistakes in my life. Misjudgments. I have explored my sexuality, and that is why I know this issue so strongly. What I believe at this hour, what I have believed ever since I met my children, is that God had a plan bigger than I was. God brought the best woman into my life, Allison Bork, that I could ever have. She's loyal. She loves me. She fears God, and we celebrate Sabbath every single solitary weekend. My children, who count on me every day to be balanced in my judgment. At the end of the day, I gauge them on whether or not I've done a good job. Well, I think if you had the opportunity to speak with them, they would tell you that I have. I believe that all of humanity has the opportunity to succeed. If freedom in America is going to flourish, then it must flourish all over the globe. To my Pentagon tonight, to my troops serving overseas, to the President of the United States of America, and to our Republican candidates running for president, be consistent. I've always said that all family begins in the home. I fail from time to time, so do all fathers and mothers. So do all children. Our job is to embrace that failure and make it better. We can do better the next time. Only if we're ready to do so. Ladies and gentlemen, the reason I'm speaking to you tonight is because of my country. My country gave me the opportunity to try again. They gave me a second chance. The one thing I will say tonight is, since I have known Allison, I have made mistakes in our marriage, but I have never, ever, ever committed adultery outside of our marriage. I've never been disloyal to my wife, nor will I ever be under any circumstances. And if you ask me a question, and it is asked correctly and with respect, I will tell you the truth. But if you're all about tearing people down, you're dealing with the wrong guy. The only person that can tear me down is my wife, my children, and my God. My party does not dictate what I believe. Some of my closest friends will tell you they can't dictate what I believe. I believe what I believe from the heart. I believe that all religions in this country should have their say and be free to worship so long as they do not encroach upon the rights of another. Every political affiliation in this nation should have the right to speak their minds, including the Wall Street protesters, as long as they do not encroach upon the rights or authority of another. The problem with the Wall Street protest is simply this: when you defecate on police cars, when you hide behind a Wall Street protest, when you know that you have no reason to be there, because you have no reason, you have no idea why you're there, then you're sorely mistaken in your politics. I'm here tonight speaking to you because I do believe in something. I believe in family values. Not necessarily the way my party defines them, but the way God led me to them. Now, I will be honest with you and straightforward. I do not believe I have a mandate from God, but I surely believe that I've been blessed by Him. So I will listen to you, and I will listen to your arguments. I will listen to the American people, and I will stand up for what I believe in against party, Republican or Democrat. As a registered Republican, I am pained to the core that my party lost that election against Jerry Brown for governor of California. But I also recognize the fact that you have to look the American people in the eye and tell them the truth. What I'm telling you tonight is my party, the Republican Party, has been wrong. But the Democratic Party has been wrong a hell of a lot longer. If you look at Jimmy Carter and Barack Obama, Bill Clinton, since Ronald Reagan, is one of the best presidents we've had in history. Now, he might not agree with you when you attack his moral character, but you elected him as a president, not as a husband. You elected him as a president and as a leader, not as a father. That is a family issue. And the one thing I will promise you, as long as I'm involved in politics, as long as you, the American people, will allow me, it is to keep the United States government and the state governments out of your bedroom and out of your personal life. If you ask Herman Cain tonight, I'm sure he would agree. Ladies and gentlemen, Barack Obama was correct. It is time for change. But it is a time for change that we can really believe in. A time for change when the American people no longer have to worry and fear their government. When we can brace them up to go to the polls. When we can brace them up to do their constitutional duty. If the American people are already braced up, as my critics will say tonight, then why does Congress have the lowest poll ratings, the lowest popularity ratings in history? Why is Barack Obama under Jimmy Carter's poll ratings? A lack of confidence, folks. A lack of faith. Tonight, I ask you, the American people, to forgive me of my errors, and I will admit to every single one of them, as long as it doesn't take me away from my job. When it comes to being a father, a husband, an American, doing my duty. It is time for change, folks, and that change begins with you. Thank you. God bless you. And God bless the United States of America. Good night.